मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, या वी आर ऑलमोस्ट ऑल नियर टू कंप्लीट द चैप्टर सिमिलर ट्राइंगल्स. वी हैव ओनली वन एक्सरसाइज स्टिल हियर. ओके, डिड यू प्रिपेयर 8.1, 8.2, 8.3 वेल? सो प्रैक्टिस ऑल दोज क्वेश्चंस, प्रैक्टिस द थ्योरम्स, प्रैक्टिस द क्वेश्चंस. ओके, आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग द चैप्टर आई विल सेंड यू सम इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस ऑल्सो. क्लियर? राइट नाना. Now let us see the next theorem. See in page number 215, theorem 8.7. I read the question. If a perpendicular is drawn from the vertex of the right angle of a right triangle. See here, I have taken a right angled triangle ABC. Okay. If a perpendicular is drawn, see, a perpendicular is drawn. We have drawn the perpendicular BD. Is drawn from the vertex of the right angle. See, vertex of the right angle, that is B. Okay, to the hypotenuse. So this perpendicular is drawn to the hypotenuse. Clear? Right, Nana. Then the triangle on both sides of the perpendicular. So for this perpendicular, we have two triangles. See the triangle 1 and this is triangle 2. The two triangles on both sides of the perpendicular are similar to the whole triangle. That means we need to prove that the triangle ADB is similar to the triangle ABC, and the second triangle BDC is again similar to the whole triangle ABC, and another one it is given here and to each other. They are also similar to one another. That is, ADB is similar to triangle ABDC. Okay, triangle ADB is similar to triangle BDC. What did you understand the question? So, according to the question, we have taken a right angle triangle and we have drawn a perpendicular. So, that's what we write. The given ABC is a triangle. Angle B is equal to 90 degrees and BD is perpendicular to AC. Is the perpendicular we have taken there. And we need to prove the three cases. The first case is triangle ADB similar to triangle ABC. Now I go to the first case. Okay. So now I am taking the first case. Now in the proof. In the proof we take the first case. In triangle ADB and triangle ABC. In triangle ADB and triangle ABC. Now I suppose to cut the figures and draw here. I draw ADB. See, observe carefully. This is ADB and another triangle is ABC. ABC. If you observe, angle D and angle B are both equal to 90 degrees. Angle D is equal to angle B is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, guys. And you can observe that angle A is the common angle in both of them. I say DAB is an angle and CAB is the same angle. Now it represents the same angle. Angle DAB is equal to angle CAB, which is same angle. Okay, the two angles of one triangle are equal to the two angles of another triangle, then the two triangles are said to be similar. Okay, therefore triangle ADB similar to triangle ABC. So the first question is completed. Now we go to the second question. What is the second question? We write in the same manner. You observe carefully. We write in the same manner. So what is the second question? BDC is similar to triangle ABC. I take the same. In triangle BDC and triangle ABC. Now I split the figures and draw here. See, this is your triangle BDC and this is your bigger triangle ABC. If you observe, angle D and angle B are equal to 90 degrees, same as here. Angle D is equal to angle B is equal to 90 degrees. And also you can observe one more thing here, that angle C is the common angle in both of them. isn't it? See here, DCB is the angle and ACB is the same angle, doesn't change. So you write here angle DCB is equal to angle ACB, same angle. Okay, again the two angles of one triangle are equal to the two angles of another triangle, then they are similar to each other. Very good, Amma, very good. Therefore triangle BDC, BDC similar to triangle ABC. See, when you have proved the first one and second one, what is common in these two? Very good, Nana. ABC is common. Very good, very good. Now if I remove this common from 1 and 2, you can say the third one from 1 and 2, I can say that triangle ADB similar to triangle BDC. This is your third proof. The third question is also completed. Did you understand, everybody? Is it clear? Very good, Nana. Now right. This is most important theorem, Nana, because basing on this theorem, we have one more important theorem, that is nothing but Pythagoras theorem. Now we are going to the second theorem, which is called Pythagoras theorem. But this theorem was mainly proposed by Indian mathematician Baudhayana. So this Pythagoras theorem is also called as Baudhayana theorem. Remember, in the examinations, they ask you state and prove Baudhayana theorem. At the time, you should not say that we don't know Baudhayana theorem. Okay? So Pythagoras theorem was long before stated and proved by Mr. Baudhayana. So this theorem is also called as Baudhayana theorem. So let us see the theorem. Okay? In a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides. Most important statement. In a right triangle, so I am taking a right triangle ABC. Okay, the square of the hypotenuse, so we need to prove that one. The square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides. So what is the hypotenuse here? AC square is equal to sum, sum means plus, of the squares of other two sides, that is AB square plus BC square. Okay, Pythagoras theorem, in a right triangle, yes, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides. Now, I take a construction. What is the construction? Draw BD line segment perpendicular to AC line segments. So, this one, what I have drawn earlier in the previous question, now I have made that one as the construction. Is it clear? My answer is completed. Yeah, yes, yes. Yes, if you understand the previous theorem, then it is very simple for you. See, here the two triangles are similar. We have shown that one, ADB similar to ABC. Now observe carefully what are the sides here. I want to take AB, here is AC. So I write here AB by AC is equal to, here AD and here is AB, AD by AB. Now make a cross multiplication. So what do you get? AB square is equal to AD into AC. So this is one, what we need. AB square is equal to AD into AC. This is one. So by the same proof, I have taken this one. Similarly, come here down. What can we write here? BC is here AC. So BC by AC is equal to, here CD and here is BC, CD by BC. You make the cross multiplication. What do you get here? BC square is equal to AC into CD. This is the second one. You got AB square, you got BC square. You want to add AB square and BC square. So let us take that one. Okay. This is theorem 8.8, Nana. Pythagoras theorem. Okay, alright. Now I am going to take that one. 1 plus 2 implies AB square plus BC square is equal to, what is AB square? AD into AC. plus what is BC square CD into AC. So what is common for in both of them? AC. So you write AD plus CD into AC. If you see the figure, AD plus CD is equal to AC. So which is equal to AC square. So AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. So at last you write, therefore AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Okay guys, so the first theorem is most important. Today I said you theorem 8.7 is most important. If you learn that theorem, Pythagoras theorem is dead easy for you. Okay, write these two theorems, practice them. We will talk in the next class. Bye.